Hello, my name is Rainer Hanekamp. This is Engineers with the latest updates from the Angular community every week. Angular 19.1 is out and it comes with at least three main new features. The first is HMR for templates. If you are in development, serve mode, and you change the template, then until now the browser did a reload. That means the state of the application was reset. In 19.1, only the template updates itself. This even works for single file components. In Angular 19, we got a warning when there were unused imports inside of a component, directive, or pipe. With 19.1, we have now a schematic, which can remove them. Unfortunately, it is not coming as an ESLint role. Hopefully, that's just a question of time. Until then, you can always run it in the Git Hook. And for those of you who are using the ng template outlet, you cannot directly access the component instance if there is one. The monthly Q&A session took place and Jeremy showcased the new resource function. He highlighted that it's not going to be a replacement for the HTTP client, but a very generic function for any asynchronous task we want to link to a signal. So instead of HTTP, it could also process an access to the IndexedDB or tRPC. Jeremy again confirmed the plan for optional Rx shares, but he elaborated a little bit on what that actually means for the future of RxJS in Angular.
With everything we're doing with signals and the RxJS interop package is to make it so that RxJS is optional. It's not on the critical learning journey for Angular. New people can come, they can use Angular, they don't have to use RxJS. But when you do choose to use RxJS, that integration is better than it ever has been.
Another confirmation was that the HTTP resource and the signal forms will come soon. According to Minko Getjeff, the product lead of Angular, the plan for 2025 will be to get zoneless very quickly from experimental mode to developer preview. Signal forms should also arrive, but also the template driven and the reactive forms will also get support for signals. Karma should finally be replaced with the modern web test runner, and for selectorless, for the beginning just the RFC. Selectorless means that we have just one import instead of two for components, pipes and directives. The Angular strategy is heavily based on the outcome of the developer survey. This time, the sample size was 10,000. Surprisingly, to put it short, the feature that most people expressed negatively was RxJS. And the most positive one was signals. Sometimes technical discussions center around defining a right term for a certain thing. Common example in Angular is the discussion if the inject function is a service locator pattern or a dependency injection. Unfortunately, very often in these discussions, the main thing goes away, namely, what's the problem with the service locator? Mathieu Riegler wrote now an article where he is discussing exactly that. He says inject is more dependency injection because the dependencies don't show up somewhere but are defined in the construction phase. Inject uses Angular SDI, and we can separate the implementation from what the consumer requires. On the other side, you can violate inject if you are running run in injection context, because then this declarative style at the very beginning gets lost. In a second article, Mathieu also published a decision tree, which guides on finding the right signal-based type function for your problem. The term Rspack will probably show up very often this year. It's a JavaScript bundler like Webpack and ESLint, but promises better build time. It comes from ByteDance, that's the company behind TikTok, and it primarily solves their need, which is a huge codebase monorepository environment. It is written in Rust and it's compatible to Webpack. Angular doesn't officially support it, but Colm Ferry from NX has been working on a prototype. The first version now is available and it's quite promising. You can learn more about it by heading to ng-rspack build on GitHub, following Colm Ferry, or read an article by Manfred Steyer. And that's it. Wish you a nice weekend. See you in the next episode. Goodbye.